Hello everyone, welcome to Art History Shorts, and I thought it'd be really fun for the month of October to every week talk about a different painting that is kind of like a scary Halloween theme. And so this week we'll be talking about Artemisia Gentileschi's Judith Slaying Holofernes from 1620. And this painting has got blood, it's got gore, it's got our two final girls, Judith and her maidservant, Abra, and I just thought it'd be a really good one to start with. So a little context about this painting before we kind of get into it, about the time period. It was painted in the Baroque period, so it emerged from the Renaissance, and despite it having initial criticisms, it became a really popular style in the 17th and 18th century. It could be seen in music from this time, literature, architecture, sculpture, and of course painting. The Baroque art was about embracing theatricality and drama. It was about being grand and ornate and lush and sensuous, and about movement and tension. It was about heightened chiaroscuro, the light and the dark, like just really dramatic, shadows and light, and an exaggeration of it. So the artist Caravaggio really encapsulated the Baroque style of art, and many artists were influenced by him. Artemisia Gentileschi's father actually being one of them. He was an artist, and because Artemisia was a woman, she could not participate in the all-male apprenticeships, so she was taught by her father, so also influenced by Caravaggio. Gentileschi is probably the most well-known female artist of this time. There were others, there weren't many, but she did achieve recognition and success while she was alive. So also important to note is that the Catholic Church had started its counter-reformation against the Protestant Reformation, started in the 16th century and went into the 17th century. And the Catholic Church in Italy was also the leading patron of art. And so the art that they commissioned really had a pro-Catholic, they wanted to communicate a pro-Catholic message. So the story that's being depicted, it's a biblical story. It's about Judith. She is a young Jewish widow, and she pretends to offer the Assyrian army that's about to attack her town. She's about to, she says she's going to offer them information to gain access to their camp. Holofernes is the general of the Assyrian army set to attack, and he was so taken by her beauty, he invites her to dine with him. He gets drunk and passes out, and Judith and her maidservant, Abra, they take advantage of this, and they kill him, and she saves her people. The story was a very popular one with the Catholic Church at the time because it was an example of victory of virtue over vice. And Judith was seen as a defender of the church. The Catholic Church was engaged in conflicts with the Protestants and the Ottoman Empire, and they used Judith as a symbol of their victory. Many other artists also painted this scene because of its popularity, including Caravaggio, who painted his version of it 20 years before Artemisia's. Their versions of the beheading are often compared, and I am going to talk about them a little bit in a second. So this is actually Gentileschi's second version of this particular scene. And it's probably her most well-known painting overall. She actually did four paintings, I believe, of the story of Judith, including the moment after the beheading with Abra is wrapping up Holofernes's head to show the victory. Many of Gentileschi's other paintings too, they depict strong heroic women, and it's hard not to read this piece as a feminist piece. Many have interpreted as a kind of outlet for her feelings, or reaction to having been raped as a young woman by a family friend. So now, knowing some of the context behind this painting, let's talk about the actual painting. All the classic Baroque elements are seen here. It's dynamic, it's got movement, we see Judith in this moment of beheading Holofernes. We can feel the struggle, you know, Abra trying to hold him down and her like cutting off his head, the blood spurting from his neck. It's like caught in this moment of stillness, and it's highly theatrical and dramatic. And another common quality of Baroque art is the figures or the space is kind of painted in diagonals, and this helps create a feeling of three dimensions. It kind of brings the viewer into it, or the figures are kind of escaping the canvas or coming out at you, and it really draws the viewer into the piece. It's like you're part of it. You're in the action with the climax. The point of the scene is right in the foreground. It's right there for you to see. And the use of the way that Holofernes' body is cutting across the canvas in a diagonal, and then Judith's arms are coming in from the other way, really puts you right in the foreground, right where the beheading is happening. The climax of the scene is you're right there in it. And another way that she's kind of keeping you in there with the tenebrism of it, the dramatic light and dark. The background is all, it's dark, it's black, and you know, in contrast to this, you know, single light source on the other side, highlighting the figures. It's this tension created right there in the middle. Speaking of the middle, something I really love about this painting is that at the center of it is Judith's hand gripping the sword. So it's this moment of this woman's strength is right there in the middle of the painting. And there's the strong use of the chiaroscuro, the highlighting of the light and the dark, and a really strong contrast in half of Judith's face. His face is completely dark and, you know, highlighted by the light on the other side. So all really classic Baroque qualities here. How does Gentileschi's version compare to Caravaggio's version? I think the most notable difference is the mood of each painting. Both depict the violence of this scene, the beheading, but we have two very different ideas of the women and how they're shown. With Gentileschi's version, Judith and Abra have this feeling of dark intimacy with violence. Yet they're not enjoying cutting off Holofernes' head, but there's a determination, a focus. There's a strength there. With Caravaggio's, we kind of see more of the moral dilemma happening on Judith's face. There's an aversion to it. There's almost an unwillingness, and then to perform this task. And then we've got, you know, Abra is very different. She's kind of like shocked at what she's seeing. You know, she's waiting with this bag. She's more of a passive participant in what's happening. This Judith encapsulates more of the virtue than the victory of the moment that the Catholic Church was looking to showcase with this story. I certainly have my favorite of the two, and feel free to comment below what you think. Artemisia Gentileschi is such a talented painter. Like I said, this is probably her most well-known painting, but there are quite a few that show her skill. They just blow me away. And if you look up the one that I was talking about, Judith and her maidservant, the scene after, the detail, it's really incredible. The way she paints fabrics is beautiful. So I hope you enjoyed the first week of the Halloween themed paintings that I'm going to be talking about. If you want to see more from this month or after that, please subscribe if you enjoyed it. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up for the YouTube algorithm. And I'd love to read any comments you have or suggestions of paintings you want me to talk about. So thanks so much. Bye.